One day on the autopsy, one day on the school being developed, 2 days on supply drop. We were trying to meet up with a new region. 7 available soldiers, 4 wounded.
We've done what we can to honor our fallen soldiers, Commander. It's not much, but it gives our people a chance to pay their respects.
It's a bar slash memorial. Fallen soldiers. Those 2 characters that have to die, and Daniel McSween. The first person between this game and Dark Soul and Darkest Dungeon to be named after a viewer and dead. Very dead. Whoopsie. It happens. So that's there. So out of all of our soldiers, are they all named right now? Everyone except for the rookies, I think. Yep. Alright, we'll see how that goes. Next time I get an engineer, a specialist, I'll name one after, I'll be naming the next one after Wanderbot, because I forgot to do that, and we were gonna name characters after each other, and I'm an asshole. It happens. Don't think we need to recruit right now, because there's a bunch of rookies just hanging out, so let's go progress time. So guys, welcome back to XCOM 2. Like always, we are live streaming on twitch.tv/SebastianSB if you want to see these live on my nonsensical, all-over-the-place schedule. Technically exists. So we're making a proving ground facility. They want us to make contact with West Asia to progress the story, but I want to make contact with East Asia because they give me more money.
Setting course for East Asia.
Let's get back over there. We got interrupted, I believe, last time.
Guerrilla Tactics School, now operational.
And now we have a Guerrilla Tactics School. Trains rookies as specific class. Yeah! Now you can actually choose what your rookies are going to be instead of just being nothing. That'll be handy. Alright, let's take a look at it. Oh wow, those are giant, hilarious aliens with bloated bellies hanging out over there. That sure is a thing. Alright. Open. Soldier acquired. Train rookies a specific class. Okay. These are my rookies. Let's see, Gonzalez can undergo specified training at the Guerrilla Tactics School, studying to become a squaddy of a specific class, but they'll be unavailable for combat during the training process. Do you want to proceed? Sure. Why not? Let's give it a shot. So 5 days to become anything specific. We'll hold on to this. It takes time. So let's wait until I have a demand for a specific class. But it's good to have access to this sort of thing. Let's see, I should probably be clearing something new then, right? Let's see, we'll get 28 supplies if we clear this alien debris. Let's go ahead and start clearing out the next area. Engineer required. We have one, right? Molly Martin. Have fun there. Alright. Back to where we were.
The outcome of this research can only further our advances, Commander. The sectoid's rapid physical evolution over the past 20 years is a testament to both the aliens' mastery of genetic engineering and their pursuit of advancement, regardless of the risks.
Preliminary autopsy exam conducted by Dr. Richard Tigan, acting science officer. Although my direct surgical experience is limited, the alien's genetic manipulation of the species previously cataloged as a sectoid provides a certain familiarity in relation to human anatomy. While the earliest documented accounts of sectoids on Earth indicated examples no larger than 1 meter in height, the specimens we encounter today are nearly twice that size. Knowing full well that the aliens continue their efforts to continue to integrate human and alien DNA, my findings here only reinforce the notion of a continuous development process. This larger sectoid variant has an even greater proportion of human genetic material, selectively combined with the intention of improving the otherwise limited physical capabilities of the original. With enhanced psionic capabilities and greater overall strength, I'd say they've succeeded. Artigan. Yeah, none of that's really good news for us, but we can get a mind shield and psionics. Mind shield. The mind shield is a powerful psionic artifact, rendering soldiers completely immune to any negative mental conditions, including panics, mind control, stuns, and disorientation. Probably expensive to equip your whole party with them, though. And gives you less versatility in other slots, of course. The faceless. You can go after troopers faceless, a resistance radio. That's part of the story right now. I should probably go into that. Modular weapons. Let's do the weapons first. It's only 2 days.
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available. I certainly admire the courage and tenacity displayed by our troops in the field. They face a...
I guess that cuts him off. My bad. This should be done before we make contact.
Priority message coming through, Commander. Putting it on screen now.
Or this will happen.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
All right, all around good stuff happened. We got 2 new staff. Cool. Oh, did we just get those 2 just now? That's also good. 140 supplies. All right.
Commander, we have intel suggesting the aliens are working on developments that threaten our ability to stop the Avatar project. We can conduct guerrilla operations to disrupt one of these efforts, but we'll have to choose carefully. We don't have the resources to intercede everywhere.
Sometimes it just feels like the game's shouting at you. You clicked on something. Ah, bad! Picked one of these bad things, now! We have received intel regarding the aliens' current activities. Try to foil one of these events before they can be enacted. Alright, counter operations will be available soon. Next retaliation strike is 4 weeks. So you're gonna hunt XCOM. And a UFO hunts with the Avenger. That's very specific. Something's going to hunt us in 4 weeks, is that what we're saying? If they keep imprisoning and torturing people, eventually someone's gonna talk. Rapid response. The aliens improved their threat response procedures, guaranteeing reinforcements on all guerrilla ops for a month. Ooh. Reinforcements all the time, that's pretty bad too. Do you click on one? No? So the counter operations will be available soon, but not now. So for now, we don't get to do anything about it. Alright. Interesting.
Commander! The Resistance has a hidden cache of resources stashed outside of Advent's reach. But that means we'll have to fly over and scan the area if we want to recover this stuff for ourselves.
We can get to that, just give me a moment. I can ignore it for now, can't I? There's just like a cache over there? There it is. 3 days. Let's finish what we're doing real quick.
I do not think I could have predicted this outcome.
Though it is intriguing.
Alright. We've had the troops digging through scrap piles and looting corpses, and at this point it's safe to assume they're on constant vigil for anything that we'd use to improve our gear. All the raw materials in the world won't mean much if we can't find a use for them, but I think this modular weapon system's a good start. Having pushed for our existing designs about as far as I thought possible, the integration of a few key alien components provided the much-needed stability we've been looking for. With these modifications in place, we should be able to attach larger upgrades for even more firepower. The troops will like that. Elshen. Magnetic weapons! Alright. Commander, researching the Advent modular weapons allows us to reverse engineer their system for our own use. Any weapon upgrades found in the field can now be attached directly to our soldiers' weapons and to provide tactical bonuses. Whoa. So if we find upgrades, we can just plop them on. Is it time for that radio? Probably. Maybe. Let's get into that radio.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
Have fun.
What can I do for you, Commander?
Let's see here. Let's look into building an item here. Smoke grenades. Nanoscale vests. So not a lot going on here. Okay. Actually, can I not afford that? Oh, it was telling me that my monthly income is 140. I can't just buy another medkit right now. Alright.
I wonder if this is what it was like in the old days. Always on edge, ready for a fight on a moment's notice. Certainly keeps you on your toes.
Yep, until your toes get blown off. It's fun.
Commander, we've got local resistance forces waiting to make contact, but we'll have to make the first move.
I'm trying very hard. There's been so many interruptions. They just won't let me do it. Why is there an exclamation point here? Oh, gain intel back at town. Not right now, I'm doing this. Vigilo confido, Commander. The people of East Asia stand ready to help XCOM however we can. New income, 77 supplies.
New regional contacts located.
There we go, we're gonna have more money now. It'll be easier to buy medkits. Let's see, so now we're going to Indonesia. Oh, I mean, that's a new option. Supply drop available. We still have a supply drop from the Resistance awaiting pickup. We could use additional supplies to purchase weapons and armor. Yeah, I understand how that works. So how much is this one worth? 70? Yeah, the one they want you to make contact with worth is actually worth the least. It's probably has other rewards attached to it, though, or it might be even easier to make contact with. Overgrown checkpoint. Resistance has detected activity of interest here. If the Avenger scans the area, XCOM can investigate these reports. Maybe later. Let's get the supplies for now.
Avenger plotting new course.
I like how they've kind of redone this area. The changes they've made are kind of interesting to how this map works. Alright, before we go forward in time, should I consider... Nah, I can't exactly buy anything right now. Yeah, we just need time to pass, basically. Alien debris cleared. 28 supplies. Boom, look at this place. So we could build our proving ground that we have to build for the story. It'll reduce our income by 25, basically, and require 3 power, which is the rest of what we have. Alternatively, there's a power relay. If I buy the proving ground, we're gonna run out of money. I don't know if I want to throw it away right now. I might wait for a little bit more money to come in first. Maybe. So, on topic of the power relays, though, do they have a synergy thing here? Let's see, building relays will increase the total power output of the Avenger, allowing for further expansion upgrades. No immediate mention of the idea of building them next to each other. I think in the previous game, you'd build your power generators next to each other, and that'd make you basically generate more power as a bonus. Come on, supplies. 46. We've collected the resources at this location. The Resistance should provide us with additional supplies in a few weeks. Cool.
Commander, to aid in your efforts, we have gathered additional resources and staff at Resistance Headquarters for your use.
Alright, new staff.
Setting course for the Arctic territories.
Oh, we have to do that back at town. Okay. I mean HQ. Words.
Welcome,
things.
Commander.
Hello. Scanning bonus medical assistance. 25 supplies. Instant. While the Avenger is located here, Resistance HQ provides extra medical staff and resources to help our soldiers recover from injuries faster, so we can come back here to make them get better faster. That's interesting. Purchasing this ability will overwrite the current Resistance HQ scanning bonus. The scanning bonus may only be modified once per month. So there's different scanning bonuses. Do I have a current scanning bonus? Rapid construction. Let's see, build helps you do projects on the Avenger faster, okay? We also get these two scientists for a lot of money. Like all of my money. They're both born in 2008. That's how you know this game's from the future. These people are currently 7 years old. It's maybe 6 years old. But they are expensive, so I'm probably not gonna deal with them right now. But they will be handy. One scientist and one engineer. Keep that in mind. Keep them in mind at least. Passing time gets intel. I don't think we need more intel right now. We have other options around here. Yeah, activity of interest. Let's investigate.
Avenger plotting new course.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
I'm really surprised we haven't had a fight yet. Got a radio built. The Avenger serves our purposes adequately in terms of coordinating our communications network, but if we hope to increase our range and reach out every possible outlet, we will have to do more. A series of carefully positioned relay towers, I think it's supposed to say positioned with ED or something, would suffice. Assuming we can miniaturize the technology we've adapted from the alien's own communications equipment, it may be difficult to balance the requisite power levels versus the increased chance of detection, but this is our best chance to expand our capabilities. With the increased coverage, we can expect the efficiency of local resistance operations to improve, strengthening the groups working within range of the towers. Okay. Magnetic weapons, that's expensive. We can do some Might as well just do some quick autopsies to be able to develop new things. They're really short time frames.
Knowing that my past surgical experience is limited, I am sure the crew appreciates that I hone my skills on fallen advent forces before triaging our own wounded. To the uninitiated, the common advent trooper is seemingly human. The aliens have disguised its most glaring divergence from the human form with a carefully designed helmet.
It's the shock troopers they use to just sort of pretend that there's still normalcy on Earth. And that not everyone's a horrible monster everywhere. Unstaffed engineer, low scientists. Right. I guess I might as well just... I guess there's not much reason not to just clear this place out, huh? We have an engineer that needs to do something, I guess. Actually, no. Do I, leave for that excavating? I have
just
money.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
It's something major I want to try to look into here. There's the mine shield. One sectoid corpse, 45 supplies. Okay. Medkits, 35. Smoke grenade. Don't have a lot of options yet. We'll get there, though. And our facilities options. I guess we still don't really have much we want to do. Yeah, here's all the other options, though, that were not highlighted before because we didn't have the money. Workshop. Engineers can be staffed in workshops, creating unique gremlin drones, which can be sent to staff any adjacent room or facility. So a workshop must assist the local chambers. Power relay. Every facility aboard the... Was it three power? Every facility above the Avenger requires power to remain operational. Building relays will increase the total power output of the Avenger. They rearranged them a little bit. The lab's up here now. Let's see. Scientists can be staffed in labs to provide additional resistance to Dr. Tigan, further increasing the speed of all research projects. So, if I don't build a lab, does the extra scientist just not do anything? Advanced Warfare Center. Once the AWC is built, soldiers will gain the bonus ability outside their current class. Right, we've covered that a little bit. Resistance comms. Increases the number of regions that can make contact with. Further contacts can be gained by staffing an engineer here once construction is completed. That seems noteworthy. Let's go ahead and throw that one in.
Commander, we've pushed our current power systems to the limit. We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
Yep. I understand that. Molly Martin's increasing construction speed by 50%. Bam. There you go. Yeah, we'll need to build a power source next. But that's for later. That's next time.
Commander, based on my research in collaboration with Shen, I believe we can reduce the intel costs of contacting additional regions by building radio relay towers along our network. The further a region is from a relay, the more it will cost us in intel. So I would suggest building relays along the remote edges of our existing network. I believe the Resistance will be grateful for the construction of these relays. They may reward us in kind.
So they want us to build towers like this one? Install radio relay, 2 to 4 days. Costs 50 supplies. Once a radio is installed, Resistance East Asia will increase their regular collection to 116 supplies. The intel cost of making contact with nearby regions will also be reduced. Okay, that means the amount of additional supplies I'll get is actually almost equal to what I'm spending on cost in the first place. I'm just a little hesitant to blow what is currently the majority of my money right now, though. But I think I'll be getting into that relatively soon, just if not right now. Let's try to finally burn through this thing. What is that over here? Asia spare parts? All proving ground project costs are reduced by 50%. Oh, that's the Asia bonus? Like risk, where you take over the entire continent? Make contact and install radio relays on this continent to receive this bonus. Okay, that's exactly what it is. It's your monopoly slash risk thing. You want to take over all of Asia, and then... And then you get your Proving Grounds bonus. New targets acquired. We've acquired new targets of our guerrilla operations against the Advent, Commander.
Commander, with the number of contacts we've established, we're getting requests for support from multiple sites around the world. Unfortunately, we only have the resources to respond to one of them. The decision is yours.
This is where we're going to be countering those one of the two dark events, isn't it? Let me see. Dark event, hunt XCOM. Dark event, rapid response. Yep, that's exactly what's happening here. Alright, so, Operation Sky Giant, you destroy an enemy relay. Supposed to be easy, and if you defeat it, we'll stop getting reinforcements all month during our missions. And in the New Arctic, if we take out this one, we'll avoid Hunt XCOM, which launches a UFO to Hunt XCOM. I don't actually know what that scenario entails, but I'm sure it involves getting attacked by UFO. Getting hunted by UFO definitely sounds problematic. 113 intel versus a scientist. A scientist is a pretty good bonus too. Huh. It's a hard call a little bit. One of my concerns is that rapid response extra reinforcements could be a big problem because we could be getting... We already have some difficulty on some of the missions. If they get reinforcements in addition to that, that could be really tough for our missions. So I'm kind of worried about that one. I also like the idea of a scientist. Getting hunted by a UFO could be really bad, but I don't know how much I should worry about that. Oh well, it'll be a learning experience.
Setting course for Sector 14, East Asia.
Alright, current setup. We have two assaults, one sniper, one engineer. Let's see if I can switch you out for a gunner. Grenadier, I mean. Forgot about the pants. That's amusing. Alright. So we're just not allowed to... Yeah, we need advanced armor to use the second slot at all. As has been mentioned, I should give the med kit to... Oops. Gotta take it off the other character first. Let's give you a grenade. Because you could use the medkit. Because you're able to heal people at distance with your drone. I think this is the setup I want. Everyone's got their names. Atheist Horowitz, Sheerland, and Balls. See how this goes. I'm finding you can play this game for a shockingly long time before a mission shows up.
Ranger deployed.
We're in the pipe. 5x5.
All right, here we go.
Signal triangulation has locked in the location of a hidden alien communications relay uploading data to the Advent network in this area. Disrupting the aliens' progress is our highest priority, so we're moving to destroy the relay before they complete the transfer. Terminate any hostile forces operating in the area. Secure the site. Destroy that relay.
Alright, kill all bad guys, destroy relay. Let's see if grenades help.
Menace 1-5, the communications relay is up ahead. Move in and destroy the target.
Alright, straight ahead. We're currently not seen. Do we have any... in line of sight enemies anywhere? Not yet. All right. Let's approach with our assault type character first. Can't make it to full cover. This is all half cover. It suffices to some extent at least. Is anyone close enough just to actually stand by this thing within their turn? Yeah.
Moving on target location.
That should be some line of sight.
Stay clear of those turrets. We're still not entirely sure if they're fully automated or remotely triggered.
That thing has some range. Okay. Oh, that reminds me. I found out what might be the problem with my rotating map. Confirm. Can I just cancel you? Yeah, there we go. Save and exit. Save and exit. Alright, now if I hit E... Motherfucker! Never mind. I thought... Well, someone suggested that hitting, That's my bad. Someone suggested that E being mapped to confirm might be why it skips my turn, but nope. Unmapping that, it still skips my turn. I don't know why E skips my turn. So I can only rotate and make the map in one direction for now. Oh well. Alright. Let's rotate the camera a bit.
Headed there now.
Let's repeat that action real quick.
Stay clear of those turrets. We're still not entirely sure if they're fully automated or remotely triggered.
Alright. I'm wondering if I get on top of this building, because that should give me clear line of sight to our target. Is there there's a pipe over here. Alright, we know this guy's over here, so we don't want to go there so much anymore. Let's see. Let's progress forward with our other characters first. Because my sniper can actually... My sniper can at least, where do I want to go here? It's a bummer I can't reach all the way there. Might stop midway through instead. I can at least stop here on the way.
Moving.
Any line of sight? No? Make our win. If we get the sniper on the roof, we'll be a lot safer in general, I think. Just run right up to the window. What could go wrong? Window does not constitute cover, I don't think. Let's just go ahead and stop here, I think. No one's shown up yet.
I'm all over it.
Let's just hope we get one turn of grace period. Alright. Hello, assaults. Surprisingly I always expect them to have a bigger movement speed than they do. Let's come up to this tree here for cover. I guess that's the boundary of the map, huh? Oh yeah, there's not really much risk then of that direction being useful for cover. I'll inch a little closer to the rest of my party. We're clearly not going through that turret. There we go. Turret, nasty. There we go. Let's get you on this roof here. You'll be nice and useful up here.
On it.
Let's see what you can find up there. Please don't get spotted. Alright. Ooh, what's this? Oh, it's just saying that I'll be spotted if I go through this direction? Oh, it's because I'll hop through the window. At first I thought that was they were saying that was literally an enemy right there. So that's our goal. Haven't seen bad guys yet, just the turrets. Do turrets count as enemies I have to kill? Because they'll be a pain, unless... I guess I could just grenade them. That might not be that big of a deal. I'm obviously going to try to circumvent them for now. Let's push forward with Atheist, I guess. Yeah. Let's go up to the corner of the building.
Running.
We see anything? Oh, there they are. Oh, shit.
At first, Advent deployed non-lethal stun units for crowd control and the occasional protest. We don't see a whole lot of that anymore.
Well, that was a problem. Well, shit. And here, that whole part of the map looked like it was, it looked like we had more or less confirmed there was nothing there. Oh, no. That went bad really quickly. Okay. It says red. Is it because that thing has line of sight, doesn't it? Oh, you son of a bitch. Well. I may have gone too far in a few places. Let's at least get around this corner from the turret.
On target position now.
Take our shot. 56% chance of killing? No. 4-6 damage. It's iffy. That's how iffy it is.
Shot failed to connect.
Alright. Not a good spot to be in. I should probably just try to get behind the wall from here before that thing kills me. Full cover over here. Go, go, go. Alright, we're gonna be in trouble here. Is that not an attack? You're not gonna oh, you're gonna attack though. Welp. And that's why we don't charge ahead. Hey, stop that. You're being rude. None of that. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. Hey, sword friend. How do you feel about swords? Where did this guy go? Do we just not have line of sight on them right now? Let's get it. There he is. Hey, friend. Nice to meet you. I'm just gonna go... Nope, not there. Over in that corner. And stab. Friend. Uh-oh. Alright. Mixed feelings about the recent events here. So you could flank this guy. That would do something. Lightning hands. Fire your pistol at target. Does not cost an action. Right, that's a great action. 100%. Alright. Slightly less effective than I was hoping. Still. Now we can do an extra attack, though. Could you perhaps be a little more dead? That'd be really nice of you to do. Let's see, so the main gun is a minigun, right? Yeah. Otherwise, there's the frag grenade. So can I just run right up to him right here and just shoot him in the face? Fire weapon. Hey, friend! You're looking a little weird. He's not dead. Oh, crap. Well. They're a lot less dead than I was hoping. Okay, this mission's off to a bad start. Oh, that would have been so cool if he counterattacked him to death.
Oh, come on.
Yes! At least that happened. At least that happened. Tell me the gun can't shoot me. Ooh, thank goodness. Alright. That could have gone worse. Sniper took a hit. But hey, my specialist isn't dead yet. That's a good sign. Let's see, sniper. Can you take him from here? 41% is not ideal. But if I flank him...
Moving to designated coordinates. I've got eyes on advent troops.
Oh, there's more over there. Not the best sign. Oh. I guess it was loading. Alright, things are mixed right now. Oh, I can't even target that guy. I cannot target the guy below me. Apparently. He can't just lean over the rail and shoot him? Why? That seems dumb. Oh well. Might as well try to make a mess. Come on.
This is for you.
Screw you guys. How you feeling, buddy? It's bound to make a mess of something. Alright. Well, no one's died yet, so at least there's that. At least that's something, right? Damn. Couldn't open with that one, huh?
It's down.
Okay. So Krause's last remaining turn we have. Let's get behind the dumpster for cover. Maybe we can take this guy out from here? 43% chance. Alternatively, I could shoot him with a grenade, but that seems like a waste of that amount of hit points. Let's go for it. Come on. That was a happy grunt.
Got him.
Okay, so at least the initial problems are dead. And no one died yet, but two people are hurt. What is he doing? What is he doing? Is it loading slowly or something? Oh, zombie. Okay. I couldn't tell what I was supposed to be looking at there. Jesus. Alright. Holy crap. Alright. Nothing is going well right now. So he just reanimated the corpse. If I kill him, does the corpse go back down? Because that'd be very good if he would stop being alive. Please. Please stop being alive. That's not the best hit chance either. Come on. That's something. I have two unconscious characters in a four-person party. Dear Lord. And also two people that are, like, really hurt already. Actually, yeah. Three people are hurt. how long are you unconscious for? Does that wear off? I don't know if people could even go unconscious in the last game. Son of a bitch. There's no other raiders, right? It's just this one guy over here, and the guns don't have line of sight. Is it safe to just stab this dude? Can I not stab him from that? Can I only stab him from behind or something? Huh. Let's see. This is a clusterfuck right now. Tell me you can just take this guy out. There we go.
Kill confirmed.
I don't know how corpse... I'm not entirely sure how the undead work in this game. God, we still have to try to get the data transfer done. This is the easy mission, according to the game. Yeah, he's a dumb zombie, right? He's like, crawls around. Oh, he's gonna come get me. Oh no. Miss? That's not a miss. Ah.
The alien transmission is still active and we're running out of time. Get to the relay and take it out, ASAP.
Wow. This game does not pull punches, does it? So he's just dead. Ah, oh, man. So there goes our sniper. I was working on him. And people were complaining I wasn't playing on a high enough difficulty. Jesus Christ. I could go for the side. I don't know if side zombies go unconscious or not. If I kill that guy, does he go down or not? Man, alright, we have a lot of elements here that I haven't dealt with before. I'm really hoping that since he's connected to that guy, that if I stab him, he'll just go down. Come on.
Nailed him.
So the tell me the size zombie goes down now. Ilarium core.
Object secure.
Come on. That's him dying, right? Right.
Hostiles got me flanked.
So now we have this issue.
I need medical attention now.
That's the whole reason he was standing there, of course. Ah. How many more hostiles are there? Is it just this guy? Let's get full cover in here. Motherfucker! There's three more? What? What the fuck? This seems unreasonable. Holy shit. So everyone's gonna die, right? That's it. We're just losing everyone? Oh my god. Wow. And now, yep, I have one remaining character and I can't control her. She's running around on her own now, so I guess we're just gonna watch. Jesus Christ.
They've almost completed the transfer. This is your last chance to take out that relay.
Yeah, I'd love to. I would love to take out the relay, dude. It'd be great. Jesus Christ, I'm not even playing right now. And now she's unconscious. Jesus Christ.
Avenger, all XCOM operatives are dead or MIA.
Holy shit. Wow. I'd love to hear from chat. The one big mistake I know I made is that I shouldn't have gone all the way to the corner. I ran way too far ahead with the engineer in the first place, which led to the initial conflict, but I also feel like there was waves of insanity happening at some of these points that were just, hey, look, three more enemies over here. Oh, three more, and they get to act before anything happens, and you know, that was, some of that seemed like bad luck, too. Oh, man. Well, we didn't stop the bad thing from happening. It only says one person's killed, though. It only says one person's dead, though, which is the sniper. So, at least, presumably, I still keep three of them? That's an empty ship. Does that mean they're all dead? Oh, man. Wow, I've never done that before. Like, I never beat the original XCOM, but I played, like, several hours of the original XCOM at the very least, and I never failed a mission, actually. This is a brand new experience for me. To be fair, there was like 7 brand new things happening. There was a mess of things I hadn't seen before happening there. The stun batons? Wow, so I guess they're all gone, huh? According to chat, I can rescue the ones that were captured. Yep, they're captured. Whew. Wow. Okay. I'm gonna be getting some angry comments from a few people that have those names. Oh, damn it, I like that sniper. He had 9 kills. I guess, shit, Horowitz has 14 kills, and those are like my 2 favorite characters so far to use.
Hello, Commander.
Yes, hello. Unfortunately, the advent transmission continued unabated, allowing the aliens to proceed within their work. I trust you to make the effort to improve your tactics going forward, Commander. Oh, you shut your mouth. Man. All right. Nice meeting you too, game. I'm glad that we're out in the open about what our relationship is. I have five remaining rookies. And 1 ranger and 1 specialist, and the specialist is shaken. So, which means they're more likely to flip out in the middle of the fight. Oh man. Yeah, okay. This is the worst that an XCOM has gone for me before. This is an experience. Man. Okay, that's what I get for wondering when the next fight's gonna start happening because of how long we were managing menus and stuff. Wow. I thought surely at the very least I could just jump out that window and just shoot the crap out of that thing and then we could move forward from there, but no. Just ambush and then no ability to control any of what was happening for an entire round. Ugh. The aliens approved their threat response procedures, guaranteeing reinforcements on all guerrilla ops for a month. Ah, haha. Last thing we need is more admin dropping on top of us. Yes, that is true. That's what killed me. And now it's gonna happen again. Oh my god.